Hallelujah. May peace be with all the brothers and sisters.
Hallelujah. 愿各位弟兄姐妹大家平安。
Thank God that I've come back safely to Vancouver.
感谢主，让我可以平安地回到温哥华。
So I miss everyone. It's good to see everyone.
我很想念大家，所以很高兴看见每一个人。
When I was in Hong Kong, I met with an old friend.
当我在香港的时候，我跟一个老朋友见面。
I haven't seen him for a long time.
我也很久没看到他了。
And then he asked me, oh, how's your job?
他问我说，你的工作如何啊？
我说 ，Yes, very busy. Church work is always busy.
我说，对，教会的事工是非常的忙碌。
And he said, you know, oh, I understand, because next week is Easter. Your church must have a lot of activity.
他说，哦，我知道，因为下个礼拜是复活节，你们教会一定是很忙的。
And then I told him, actually, we do not celebrate Easter.
我跟他说，其实我们教会并不庆祝复活节。
And then his eye opened so big.
他的眼睛真的很大。
I say, isn't it? This is the if I look at the news, this is a big one of the biggest celebration of your Christianity.
他说：“我看报纸，我知道这个在你们基督教里面，复活节是一个很大的节气。
All the priests dressed in white and then holding the cross, even in Hong Kong, they parade in the street, Easter parade.
甚至在香港都有复活节的游行，然后也看见一些照片是一些祭司穿着白色的祭袍。”
So he could not understand why we do not celebrate Easter.
所以他想不通为什么我们教会不来庆祝复活节。
I believe a lot of people don't understand.
我相信也很多人并不明白。
And of course, lots of our members know that we don't celebrate, but we don't understand why.
我们很多的信徒也知道我们不庆祝复活节，可是不知道为什么。
But tonight we're going to look deeply into this issue, and of course, the conclusion is we must know who and what we believe.
那今天晚上我们就要来探讨这个题目，来认识一下我们所相信信靠的这一位。
Let's turn to the book of Ephesians chapter 4 verse 14.
我们一起翻到以弗所书的第四章十四节。
Ephesians chapter 4 verse 14.
以弗所书第四章的十四节。十四节使我们不再做小孩子，中了人的诡计和欺骗的法术。被一切异教之风摇动，飘来飘去，就随从各样的异端。
Here tell us what does it mean for us to grow in the faith?
这里告诉我们什么是在主里的信心上面成长。
This means we are no longer spiritual children.
就是我们在属灵上不再做小孩子。
We have to be a spiritual adult.
我们在属灵上要做一个成熟的大人。
Because children is easily influenced by the environment and the sayings.Surrounding them.
因为小朋友很容易相信身边周遭的人对他所说的话。
However, an adult know how to make decision and discernment.
一个成熟的大人应该要懂得来分辨。
Here's a spiritual adult will not be carried about with every wind of doctrine.
这里讲到属灵的大人是不会被一切异教之风来摇动的。
Doctrine is mean teaching.
异教之风。
Doctrine, 教义。
教义。
That's mean teaching.
就是教导我们的
teaching about Christ, teaching about the Bible.
就是教导我们圣经，还有关于基督。
At the time when Paul wrote the book of Ephesians, already there are some teaching which is different than what the apostles and what Jesus taught.
在保罗写这封给以弗所的书信的时候，那时候已经有一些异端传出来，是跟基督的教训不同。
It's different than what the apostles teaching.
也跟使徒所教导的不一样。
And Paul knows that in the future there will be more of them.
保罗知道在未来这个会更严重。
So you have to know what is the truth and discern, make the judgment.
所以他告诉信徒必须要有这个分辨是非的能力。
Now we know that 2,000 years ago when Christianity was first established,
我们知道在2,000年前基督教刚刚成立的时候
was established under the influence of a lot of Romans philosophy, culture, and religion.
是在一个怎么样的情形下成立基督教的呢？是在罗马帝国的影响，还有它的文化之下。
Lord Jesus Christ tried to bring in the truth and tell the disciples to keep the truth.
主耶稣基督想要教导我们这些福音，而且要信徒全部都能够懂得来遵守。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 20.
我们来看马太福音第二十章。
Verse 20, Matthew 28, verse 20.
马太福音第二十八章二十节。
Matthew chapter 28, verse 20.
马太福音二十八章二十节。
Let's read together. One, two, three.
我们一起读。
Teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always, to the end of the age.
直到世界的末了。
Jesus said, from now until the end of the age, all of you, you have to do one thing.
主耶稣告诉他们，从现在直到世界的末了，你们必须做一件事。
Not only the apostle or the disciple, even today we have to do the same thing.
不是当时的门徒使徒而已，直到今日的我们也一样要做这件事。
That is to teach what Jesus teach and keep what Jesus tell us to keep.
就是要教导别人主耶稣所教导的，我们也必须要遵守主耶稣要我们遵守的。
Well, nothing more, nothing less than what Jesus taught.
不再多加什么，或是不再减少什么。
Until the end of the world.
直到世界的末了。
And what the devil tried to do, just like the snake, what it tried to do in the Garden of Eden.
可是今天魔鬼要对我们做的，就像当年他在伊甸园里面对亚当夏娃做的一样。
Sometimes it took away God's teaching. Sometimes it added a little bit in it.
有时候他把主的教导拿走一点，加了一点。
Sometimes it seems harmless.
看起来好像无害。
But actually, it is very, very disastrous and very bad.
可是其实是非常致命的。
Now, let's look at one of the issues is about the Easter celebration.
现在我们来看看有关于复活节的庆祝活动。
Now, we have to look at these two things separately.
我们要把这两件事分开来看。
Okay, the event, Jesus' resurrection, is a fact and is a very important event.
主耶稣复活是一个非常重要、值得纪念的事情。
ButAnother issue is whether it has to be celebrated. When should we celebrate and how it should celebrate? There's another different thing.
可是你要如何来庆祝它？是不是要用一整天来庆祝它，或是全国放假来庆祝它？是另外一件事。
So let's look at what Jesus said about his resurrection.
我们来看看主耶稣提到自己的复活是如何说的。
He did mention about his resurrection.
他是有说到他会复活。
In a couple of times, he mentioned about this.
有几次他自己有提到。
But it did not specifically tell disciples to make a day or do any form of celebration for his resurrection.
可是他没有吩咐他的门徒要用一整天、特别做一个纪念日来纪念这件事。
Or any way to be set apart to remember this event.
或者是用什么特别的方法来纪念他的复活。
Because if Jesus wanted us to do so, he would have been very specific.
因为如果主耶稣要我们这么做，他一定会讲得非常清楚。
And if Jesus tell the disciple to do so, the disciple would be very, very specific.
那如果主耶稣有教导门徒这么做，那门徒一定会把这个传下来给我们。
Jesus didn't teach about celebration of resurrection, nor did the apostle follow that.
所以就是因为主耶稣没有吩咐门徒，所以门徒就没有这样做。
Just why Jesus didn't want to emphasize to remember his resurrection.
所以就像主耶稣并没有要人们特别去纪念他的复活。
He wants us to have just only one focus.
他只要我们纪念一件事。
To remember one thing.
就是记得一件事。
To remember what?
记得什么呢?
Let's turn to Luke chapter 22.
我们来看路加福音22章。
Verse 17.
第十七节。
Luke chapter 22 verse 17 to 19.
路加福音22章17到19节。
17 to 19.
17节到19节一起读。耶稣接过杯来，祝谢了，说：“你们拿这个，大家分着喝。”18节，我告诉你们，从今以后，我不再喝这葡萄汁，只等神的国来到。19节，又拿起杯来，祝谢了，说：“你们拿这个，大家分着喝。”19节，又拿起杯来。
And we had given thanks. He
broke it, gave it to them, saying, This is my body, which is given for you.
Do this in remembrance of me. Verse 19 is very clear and specific.
第十九节特别的提到
If there's only one thing to remember using any form, any date, or any occasion, that is the death of Lord Jesus Christ.
你要特别的纪念，特别的用一个仪式来记得这件事，就是我的死。
And Jesus even make it a sacrament, make it a very, very important occasion. Every now and then, believer have to do Holy Communion to remember his death.
主耶稣甚至把它设立成一个圣礼，就是要我们以后每逢举行圣餐礼的时候，就是要想起纪念他的死。
And of course, there is a mystery associated with Holy Communion, which is related to our eternal life.
当然，圣餐礼的奥秘其实也是直接连接到我们的永生。
But Jesus was silent on his birth, and silent on his resurrection.
可是主耶稣只字未提他自己的出生，还有他的复活。
Even though he predicted, he mentioned that it will happen, but nothing should be done to celebrate it.
就连他自己也预言他即将死去复活，可是他没有要我们来庆祝这一天。
Now, however, we have to emphasize one thing.
所以我们要来明确的讲一点。
Even though Jesus did not say you have to celebrate with one day, but resurrection is a center message of the apostles' teaching.
就算主耶稣没有提到这个复活要来庆祝，可是这是一个主要的信息。
In the early days, the apostles everywhere when they do evangelism, they proclaim Jesus resurrected.
在早期门徒对外传福音的时候，他们一直都是传讲主的复活。
That is very, very important. Become the core message of Christianity.
那是非常重要的讯息，成为基督教的中心思想。
Let's turn to Acts chapter 2, verse 31.
我们翻到《使徒行传》的第二章。
Acts chapter 2, verse 31.
《使徒行传》第二章三十一节。
31 to 33.
三十一节到三十三节。
Let's read 31.
一起读。
One, two, three.
就预先看明这是讲论基督复活说。他的灵魂不撇在阴间，他的肉身也不见朽坏。三十二节，这耶稣神已经叫他复活了，我们都为这事做见证。三十三，他既被神的右手高举，又从父受了所应许的圣灵，就把你们所看见的、所听见的浇灌下来。
So this is the first message of Peter after the Holy Spirit descended.
这是在圣灵大降之后，彼得第一次对外的传福音。
And Peter emphasized one thing.
彼得特别指明一点。
First, you have to repent and you have to be baptized.
第一个就是你要悔改，然后受洗。
And then you'll receive the remission of sin. Your sin will be forgiven.
你的罪会被洗掉，会被赦免。
And then you'll receive the Holy Spirit.
接着你会得到圣灵。
And people may ask, how do we know that Holy Spirit will come down? How do we know that our sin will be washed?
人们就会问，我怎么知道我的罪有被洗干净？我怎么知道什么时候得到圣灵？
Well, the key is Jesus is not in the tomb, he has risen.
那这个关键就是主耶稣不在坟墓里，他已经升天了。
He overcome death so that if those who believe in him in the future will also overcome death.
他胜过死亡，所以你们这些相信他的人未来也必定胜过死亡。
So that is the message was preached everywhere.
所以这样的讯息就很快速的被传开了。
So rather, resurrection is being preached, being mentioned every single day. So there's no need a day, just one day, to remember this occasion.
所以接下来主耶稣复活的这个消息已经传遍了并且在每一天都被传颂着，所以并不需要有一天来特别纪念。
You don't think about this only one day in a year.
并不是我们一年只花一天来纪念这件事。
You have to preach this every single day.
你必须要每天都向人来传扬这个讯息。
It's not only for you, just to say, oh, that day is so important.
并不是说对自己来说这一天很重要而已。
But you have to be witness of the resurrection.
你必须要传讲主耶稣的复活。
And that is the message.
那是一个中心思想。
Now, let's look at some questions we have to ask ourselves.
现在我们要来问问自己几个问题。
Do we need a single day to remember it?
我们需要一天来庆祝它吗？
Something so important, that should be the every single day in your message to be the center in your mind and your proclamation.
有一些事情不是一天来纪念就够了，是需要你常常的思想。
The second question is, do we know the exact day of Jesus' resurrection?
第二个问题就是，我们知道主耶稣到底是哪一天复活的吗
？Does it fall in the today so-called Easter？
是不是今天呢
？So-called Easter celebration？
是不是复活节呢
？Of course, today is called a Good Friday。
今天是称为
耶稣受难的
耶稣受难的礼拜五。
And according to tradition, yes, Jesus did resurrected on Sunday。
根据传统，主耶稣是在星期天复活的。
And it's true, and the Bible says so。
这是对的，在圣经也有这么提到。
Let's turn to Matthew。
我们来看马太福音
，Chapter 28。
马太福音二十八章。
Matthew chapter 28。
马太福音二十八章
，Verse 1。
第一节。
Matthew chapter 28, verse 1。
马太福音二十八章第一节。安息日
，We're together. One, two, three。
一起读。
Now,
安息日将近，七日的头日，天快亮的时候，抹大拉的玛利亚和那个玛利亚来看坟墓。
Mary came to see the tomb. Here, tell us now, after the Sabbath, as the first day of the week began to dawn.
这一节告诉我们，安息日将近，七日的头一日。
So that means we know that the first day of the week is Sunday.
我们知道一星期的头一天就是星期天。
Now, we're early in the morning. Sunday early in the morning.
而且是发生在星期天的一大早。
Now when Mary go to see the tomb,
当玛利亚去看坟墓的时候
，Jesus is not there.
主耶稣已经不见了。
So we kind of assume everybody understand and agree that Sunday morning Jesus already resurrected.
所以我们看这段经文，每个人都明白，在星期天的一大早，主耶稣早已经复活了。
But if you check with the Passover calendar.
可是如果你看逾越节的这个日历
，Actually, if you look at the time, if you look at the setting of Jesus' resurrection.
如果你看看主耶稣他复活那一天
，Actually, Jesus was crucified, was arrested on the Passover night.
其实主耶稣是在逾越节前夕被抓。
The Passover dinner. 就是逾越节那个晚餐哈。
逾越节那个晚餐。
After the Passover dinner, Jesus was resurrected.
主是在吃完逾越节的晚餐之后被逮捕的。
So after the next day, I mean the next day he was crucified.
所以在隔天他就被钉十字架了。
And then the third day he resurrected.
在后来第三天，他复活。
So what we want to say here is the Easter or the so-called the resurrection of Jesus. The day actually could be traced, unlike Christmas. Not like Christmas, but the resurrection of Jesus can be estimated which month kind of we can know.
所以主耶稣他在被钉十字架并且复活的那一天，我们可以猜到大概是在哪个月份。
It's very very close in March and April because the Passover celebration is around that time.
很有可能是在三月底四月初的时候，因为逾越节是在那个时候。
However, where does this practice of modern day nowadays Easter come from?
可是今天的庆祝复活节到底是怎么来的呢
？So we have to look back up a little bit of history.
我们要来看一看历史。
Let's look at the origin of Easter celebration.
我们来看看这个敬拜还有庆祝复活节。
Actually, before Christianity was there.
是在基督教成立之前早就有了。
The whole Roman Empire worshipped different kinds of gods, and they are so-called pagan belief.
那时候在罗马帝国里面有信奉各种不同的宗教，称为异教。
They worship the sky, the star, the moon, the sun, the sky and the trees and mountains, everything you can name of, they worship.
他们敬拜很多种神，包含大自然界里面的太阳、月亮、星星，或者是花草树木。
Or the weather,
或者是天气之神。
Because people in the past they depend on weather and the sky for agricultural success.
因为以前的人，他们必须要根据天气才能够耕种。
And winter time in the northern hemisphere, you cannot grow anything.
在冬天是非常寒冷的，你没有办法让农作物来生长。
But when springs come, just like what we see in Vancouver here for the past few weeks.Or months, you can see that all things are sprouting, trees are growing, the grass are become greener.
所以当春天来临的时候，就像温哥华现在一样，我们可以看见花草树木都在生长当中。
Now, in the ancient time, people look at the sky, they observe in the winter time, the darkness hour is longer than daylight.
以前的人也明白，他们观察着这个星辰，他们发现黑暗的时刻就是。黑夜是比白天还要长的。
But when it comes to some day in March, in the end of March,
可是当日子来到三月底的时候
they discover there's a day that actually the daylight is equal to the darkness. The day hours and also the dark hours, they are the equal.
他们发现有一天日跟夜的长度是一样的。
So that time, that day is called the spring equinox.
所以他们就把那天称为春至。
So just like day hours, 12, just like northern hemisphere, maybe 12 hours daylight, 12 hour darkness.
在北半球来说，就是你会有大概12小时的日，还有12小时的夜。
And people observe that, wow, from that day on, the day seems to be conquering the death, and the light conquering darkness.
所以人们就认为说，从那一天日胜过夜，好像生命胜过死亡一样。
It seems like the God has been dead but was resurrected.
好像我们的神在冬天已经死了，可是春天复活。
So in the various culture, even before Christianity, people celebrate this kind of spring equinox and have this cultural settings and religion.
所以在基督教还没有成立之前，人们就已经这样相信，而且也这样在敬拜与庆祝了。
Next slide will show us in 2023, when is our spring equinox?
所以这张图就告诉我们在2023年哪一天是春至呢？
Actually, it's March 20th, a couple weeks ago.
是3月20号，已经过了。
In Eastern time, 5:24 p.m. Wow, on that day, Northern Hemisphere, totally equal. Day and like night time, totally equal.
东岸时间是下午5:24，就是日与夜是一样的长度。
So people celebrate that. Even thousands of years ago, they knew about this, and they celebrate spring equinox.
所以人们在几千年前就已经开始庆祝春至了。
So I look at the definition of Easter. Sometimes I ask, well, how do you know which day is Easter? Of course, we don't know, right? We just look at the calendar. We just make sure that we know which day is our long weekend.
我就很觉得很好奇，为什么以前的人知道这一天呢？因为我们都不知道，我们只是看日历的。
Oh, actually, the modern day calendar we are using is called the Gregorian calendar.
我们现在所用的月历是
from 那个中文我不晓得是什么贵格历那个月历系统啊 ，is from the Roman time, like a thousand years.
是从罗马帝国那时候就沿用下来了。
But actually, when is the Easter today?
那到底今天什么时候是复活节呢
？So by definition, the simple standard definition of Easter is the first Sunday after the full moon that occurs on or after the spring equinox.
就是在满月之后，四月第一个星期
天啊，这是春至之后的第一个 full moon 那个。
春至之后第一个满月。
So of course we don't know how to calculate, but nowadays the calendar system can kind of tell us.
现在的月历就告诉我们这些了。
So, usually the full moon on March 20 or 21st.
大概就是三月二十或二十一号的。
Equinox, sorry, equinox, spring equinox is March 20 or 21st.
春至大概就是在三月二十、二十一号。
So the full moon nowadays is about 2 weeks from that.
所以满月大概就是从那时候开始算。
So anyway, what we just share is people just in the olden days, in the Roman days, what they celebrate was not Jesus, anything. They celebrate spring equinox.
所以我们就知道在古代的复活节其实他们庆祝的根本跟耶稣没有关系。他们是庆祝他们自己的神还有春至。
It's not limited to Romans.
其实也不只有罗马人。
Next slide show us some information. In the ancient Mesopotamia, just like today's Iraq,
在以前的两河流域，就是米索波大米亚，现在的伊拉克。
The people in Sumer, they celebrate the same thing.
在苏马这个地方，他们也是庆祝一样的。
Egypt, they did the same thing.
埃及人也是做这样的事。
Greek, they did the same thing.
希腊人也是庆祝他们的。
They celebrate that God was dead, but their God resurrected.
他们很高兴他们的神从死里复活，所以他们庆祝这一天。
Now I think now maybe you get a better idea why Jesus didn't want his Christian, his believer want to do that.
现在你可能稍稍明白主耶稣基督为什么不要我们庆祝他的复活。
Because Jesus didn't want us to be like the rest of those pagan religion.
因为主耶稣不要我们跟这些异教之徒所敬拜的是一样的。
Because for other people, other religion, they celebrate that God was born someday.And then die someday, and then resurrect someday.
因为这些人他们所敬拜的神是有一天是他们的生日，有一天是他们的死亡之日。
And then they resurrect someday.
后来他们又从死里复活。
But our God, our one true God, isn't like that.
可是我们所敬拜的独一真神并不是这样。
Why?
为什么？
It's similar to why we do not celebrate Christmas.
其实跟我们为何不来庆祝圣诞节是一样的
道理。Even Jesus was born someday on earth.To save us.
就算主耶稣在历史当中的某一天出生来救我们。
But before that day, Jesus already exists. Jesus is the one true God in spirit.
可是在那一天之前，主耶稣本来就是独一真神，他本来就存在。
So there's not really a point to celebrate that the day he was born.
所以真的要讨论说他是哪一天来到这个世界就不是那么重要了。
And no need to celebrate his birth, because he is the one true God.
因为他是独一真神，我们不需要庆祝他的生日。
Same, Jesus, yes, his body was crucified on the cross, physically he died.
是的，主耶稣他是钉在十字架上，在肉身死亡。
And the third day he resurrected.
在第三天他复活。
But in spirit he is the one true God.
可是在灵里面他仍旧是那一位独一真神。
Because he and the Father are one.
因为他与父原为一。
So you cannot say that, oh, that 3 days God died, but the 3rd day God resurrected.
所以你不能说在那三天以内神死了，然后三天之后神复活了。
Let's look at how the Bible put it.
我们来看看圣经怎么说。
Let's turn to Isaiah chapter 9 verse 6.
我们翻到以赛亚书第九章第六节。
Who is Jesus?
主耶稣到底是谁？
Isaiah 9:6.
以赛亚书第九章第六节。
1, 2, 3.
一起读。
fall onto us.
因牌为我们而生，有一子赐给我们。
Unto us, a son is given.
政权必担在他的肩头上，他名称为奇妙测试、全能的神、永在的父、和平的君。
500 years before Jesus was born,
在主耶稣出生的五百年前
，Prophet Isaiah was revealed by the Holy Spirit to introduce who is that Messiah, that baby, that child going to be born.
以赛亚先知他借着圣灵告诉他，就预言了有一位婴孩为我们而生。
Now physically he was a baby because he has to be born somewhere by someone.
在肉体上他就是个婴孩，因为他必须要由妇人所生。
He has to have flesh.
他必须要有这个肉身。
He has to have a mother, has a father, and the mother have to give birth to him.
他要有一个父亲、母亲，然后母亲把他生出来。
However, who is he?
那他到底是谁
？But spiritually, a government shall be on his shoulder. That means he has power, he has authority, spiritual authority.
以赛亚先知说，政权必担在他的肩头上，表示他是有权柄的。
And his name will be called Wonderful.
他名称为奇妙测试。
The Counselor.
测试。
And the Mighty God. This son actually should be called the Mighty God.
这个婴孩就是全能的神。
He's not only the Son of God, but actually, in spirit, he is the Mighty God himself.
他不只是神的儿子，他在灵里面，他就是那位全能的神。
But because of salvation, he has to humble himself, so he introduced himself as the Son of God.
可是因为救恩的关系，所以他必须谦卑自己，告诉世人说他是神的儿子。
But actually, he is the mighty God.
可是其实他就是那位全能的神。
And then the last one is even more interesting.
最后一个。
The child, the baby, is the everlasting father.
那位婴孩居然就是永在的父。
How can you explain this?
你要怎么解释呢
？You have to think out of the box. Think out of time and space.
你要发挥你的想象力，来超越时空，来想这件事。
In the spiritual realm, in the eternity, Jesus, the Son, and the Father are one.
在永恒里面，主耶稣与父原为一。
So Jesus, even though physically his flesh died in the tomb,
所以在他的肉身死亡的时候
，Jesus, even though physically he died after being crucified on the cross,
当主耶稣他的肉身被钉十字架，然后死亡埋在坟墓里的时候
，But in spirit he never died.
在灵里面，他并没有死亡。
So you cannot say that, oh, God died for 3 days. No, God died for, okay, on the day one and then third day, he resurrected just like the pagan gods.
所以你不可以说神在那三天里面死亡，然后之后复活，就像外邦的神一样。
So our God that we worship is different than the pagan's God.
所以我们所敬拜的神是与外邦的神完全不一样。
No beginning, no end.
他没有开始，也没有结束的一天。
However, when people celebrate Easter,Just like lower downgrading Jesus, just like any other pagan god.
所以当人们在庆祝复活节的时候，其实就把耶稣看扁了，把他当成跟外邦异教的神是一样的。
Now let's look at some more history about the pagan origin of Easter.
我们现在再来看一下复活节的历史。
Why is called Easter?
为什么叫 Easter?
Especially in English, actually it's derived from a German background because in German area.In ancient time, some of them worship a springtime goddess called Astra.
这是要根据德国的历史来看，因为在以前他们信奉的一个春之神，他的名字就叫 Astra.
Of course, we know in Europe, especially Northern Europe, in German area, before they became Christian, they already have their gods.
我们知道，在北半球的欧洲，在基督教成立之前，他们就已经信奉多神了。
So the springtime goddess called Astra.
所以他们的春神就叫做 Astra.
So some historian has suggested that actually that could be the origin of the modern day Easter, the name come from.
所以现在的历史学家就说，现在的 Easter 这个名字很有可能就是从这个春神 Astra 的名字上来的。
But otherwise, how do you relate Easter, this word from the Bible? There's nothing. Doesn't sound like anything with Jesus, right?
要不然你怎么知道这个 Easter 跟圣经有关系呢？因为圣经里面根本找不到这个字。
But that God's name Astra is so sounds so familiar with Easter, and that first documented by a monk in the 8th century.
这是在第八世纪有一个和尚写下来的。
一个修士啊，
一个修士写下来的。
At that time already, Christians are celebrating the resurrection of Jesus.
那时候基督徒都开始来庆祝主耶稣复活。
Because the church has already departed from the truth, and the church had absorbed a lot of pagan religion, cultural practice into Christianity.
因为那时候的教会已经偏离真道，开始引进很多异端邪说在教会里。
And of course, in order to make this a festival, more commonly accepted, you have to relate it to a lot of local practice.
那当然，你要让这个风俗成为大家都可以接受的，你就必须跟在接地气。
When people worship Astra, they related the bunnies or the rabbits.
在人们在敬拜这个 Astra 女神的时候，他们就开始引进兔子。
Because if you know rabbit, they are very reproductive.
如果你真的知道兔子，你就会知道它其实是非常会生的。
They give birth.Even though we have a very, very difficult situation in the wild, lacking of food, but they still give birth. They are very strong.
尤其是在野外的野兔，他们可以在很艰难的环境下生下小兔。
So in order to make people understand, oh, Jesus also like a very lively resurrection, or they introduced a bunny.
所以当他们想要人们更加能接受这个复活节，他们就引进兔子，就是代表说主耶稣就像兔子一样，非常有生命力。
That is all right. Actually, before already.Already used by the pagan religion.
这个其实在以前的异教就已经这样做了。
And same as Easter eggs.
就像复活节的蛋一样。
They use the egg, the shell represent the tomb, and this and the egg come off the egg shell breaking the tomb.
他们把这个蛋的壳呢当作是坟墓，所以当这个坟墓被打破的时候，好像蛋壳被打破的时候，
wow.
生命就出来了。
You know, they are very good at marketing. You know, when you're marketing, you have to associate things, let people imagine, and then something abstract into something tangible.
他们非常会吸引人做这个市场来市场调查，然后来吸引人一起来庆祝这个复活节。
And then now.But that not only until 18th century, 19th century, when the industrialization come out.
可是在十八十九世纪，
那个工业革命啊，
当工业革命出现的时候
，Oh, at that time, you know, people can produce a lot of product, Easter egg, Easter bunny, and then sell it to people, children buying it, and then it become like a commercial. Easter become a commercial event.
所以当工厂可以大量制造这些兔子或者是复活节蛋的时候，商人可以卖给普通的百姓，然后大赚一笔，这就变成一个很大的商业活动。
So they using the name of Jesus actually is to make a lot of business.
所以他们是借用主耶稣的名字来发财。
But of course, we know that practice does not come from the Bible.
可是我们知道，以上所说的这些都跟圣经无关。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 15.
我们来看马太福音第十五章。
Matthew chapter 15, verse 8.
马太福音十五章第八节。
Matthew chapter 15 verse 8.
马太福音十五章第八节。
Let's read.
一起读。
These people honor me with their lips,
but their heart is far from me.
9.
第九节，他们将人的吩咐当作道理教导人，所以拜我也是枉然。
Jesus mentioned about there are two kind of people worship God.
这里主耶稣提到有两种人在敬拜神。
First kind of people is their heart is truly, truly follow God.
第一种人是他们的心真的是非常的跟随主。
How do you know your heart follow God?
你如何知道你的心是真正跟随主呢
？You do what God said, nothing more, nothing less.
你会不偏不倚的来遵守神的话。
And this is the true way to worship Him.
这就是一个正确的敬拜神的方式。
Worship doesn't only stop or happen in the chapel.
敬拜不只有发生在会堂里。
It's not only 1 hour in the week.
并不是一个礼拜一个小时而已。
Worship is every single day.
敬拜是发生在每一天。
Not only the ceremony, not only the rituals.
并不是只有一个仪式或是在会堂。
But how do you live your life?
是你如何在日常生活当中敬拜神。
So if you worship God, not only in the ceremony or coming to church, but you follow God all your life, then you are truly worshiping.
如果你是在每一天当中都在学着尊敬神、敬拜神，那你就是一个真正的跟随主的。
But however, there are second kind of people who try to show that they are worshiping.
可是还有第二种人，就是他们在展示他们如何敬拜神。
But actually, they are not truly worshiping God.
可是其实他们不是真正的门徒。
Who are they?
他们是怎么
？God said, "These people using their lips to worship me, to honor me."
主耶稣说，这百姓用嘴唇尊敬我。
What does it mean?
什么意思
Oh God, you know you are so great. Let me do something to honor you.
就是祷告说，主啊，你是那么的伟大，让我来为你做点什么吧。
Bring your sacrifice to honor you.
我来献祭。
To honor you.
来尊敬你。
Let me make a day to honor your birth. Let me make a day to honor your resurrection or other things.
让我用一天来纪念你的出生，让我也用一天来庆祝你的复活。
They make a lot of days to so-called honor God.
他们用很多日子来纪念主。
Well, did God like it? Did God need it?
到底主需要这个吗？主喜欢这个吗
？No, God doesn't like it. God doesn't need it.
不，主不需要，也不喜欢。
Here, what does God want us to do?
到底主耶稣要我们做什么呢
？Verse nine,
第九节。
In vain do they worship me, teaching as doctrine the commandment of man.
他们将人的吩咐当作道理教导人，所以拜我也是枉然。
God doesn't need us to add something to honor Him or do this and do that for Him that He didn't say.
神不需要我们为他特别做什么，是他没有吩咐的。
God just wants us to follow the teaching already in the Bible.
神只要我们扎扎实实 来做圣经要我们所做的事。
Do not add some human teaching inside.
不要加什么其他奇怪的东西。
Just follow what is written.
只要跟随主。
And then your heart is very close to God already.
你的心就已经与神非常靠近了。
So unfortunately, during the 2000 years of Christianity, a lot of pagan practice has been absorbed in Christianity.
所以很不幸的，在这2000年基督教的历史当中，已经有非常多的异教之风渗入。
So basically, they change everything, single thing, which is important.
所以他们已经把一些很重要的事情改掉了。
Like they take away the Sabbath, they add Sunday.
譬如说，把安息日改成主日。
Change water baptism.
也把水洗洗礼改掉。
They replace the one true God concept and they add Trinity.
他们把独一真神这个观念拿走，放住三位一体。
Change Holy Communion, change everything, remove foot washing.
也把圣餐礼改变了，然后也甚至把洗脚礼拿走。
But add Christmas as Easter.
他们加入了圣诞节，加入了复活节。
So just like they slowly they change every single thing that they can change.
所以慢慢的，基督教的里面很多东西都被改变。
But unfortunately, people think that oh, they are so-called the mainstream.
很不幸的，人们以为这才是主流。
And if you don't do that, you are rare. You are very, very, very special.
如果你不跟大家这么做，你是个奇怪的。
But after we study the Bible, after we pray, we really can cherish true Jesus Church.
可是当我们真正的读圣经之后，我们就要很珍惜真耶稣教会。
Because we are in the church, which is purely observe the pure teaching of Jesus and the apostles.
因为我们真耶稣教会才是真正纯洁无瑕的跟随 圣徒所建立的真教会。
Yes, we have our own weaknesses. Human being, we have our own weaknesses.
是的，我们人都有自己的软弱。
But in terms of teaching, TJC is really, really 100% pure.
可是在教导上来说，真耶稣教会是百分百纯洁纯正的。
It really belongs to Jesus. Really, really follow Jesus.
这是真正跟随耶稣的教会。
So we are very confident that if we are in this church, if we worship God.
所以我们必须要非常有自信，如果我们是在真教会里面。
We are not worship in vain.
我们并不是拜神是枉然的。
Can you imagine some people, they are very, very fervent, very devout, but at the end, God tell them, actually, you've been doing this all in vain because you are doing this following teachings of human as doctrine.
你可以想象，如果有人用一生来非常热忱的敬拜神，可是到最后主跟他说，你拜我是枉然的。
Because he's using human teaching as a doctrine.
因为你把人的吩咐当作道理来教导人。
Easter, celebration of Easter is not a doctrine.
敬拜或者是庆祝复活节并不是一个道理。
不是在教义里面。
也不在教义里面。
However, it was used as a doctrine to teach people.
可是他们却把它当成教义来教导人。
But coming back as a beginning that we mentioned.
可是我们回到刚刚开始说的。
Resurrection is very important.
复活是非常重要的。
Is the of Lord Jesus Christ is very very important.
是关于主耶稣一件非常重要的事。
Without resurrection, we without hope.
如果没有复活，我们就没有盼望。
Let's turn to First Corinthians.
我们来翻到哥林多前书。
Chapter 15, verse 16.
哥林多前书十五章十六节。
First Corinthians chapter 15 verse 16.
哥林多前书十五章十六节。
Let's read together.
我们一起读。
One, two, three.
因为死人若不复活，基督也就没有复活了。
Then Christ is not risen. 17.
十七节。
And if Christ is not risen, your faith is futile, and you are still in your sin. 18.
18节,
then also those who have fallen asleep in Christ have perished.
19. 19节, if in this life only we have hope in Christ,
we are of all men most pitiable. We know we don't need a day to celebrate the resurrection.
我们知道我们不需要花一天来特别庆祝复活节。
But the message of resurrection should be in our day, every single minute, every single second.
可是主复活这件事必须在我们每一天的生活里面发生。
Because if Christ did not resurrect, the dead will not resurrect.
因为如果主没有复活，我们未来也不会复活。
If Christ did not resurrect, then you don't have to believe in him.
如果基督没有复活，我们是不需要信他的。
If Christ is not resurrect, then you can just live, eat and drink and die tomorrow. Nothing happened.
如果基督没有复活，你可以每天吃喝快乐。
But Jesus did resurrect.
可是主真正复活了。
And in the future, you follow him, even though one day, sooner or later, we all end up in the tomb.
所以如果我们真正跟随耶稣，就算有一天我们会死亡。
But one day we'll resurrect like him.
可是有一天我们会跟他一样。
So that message have to be remembered not only one day in a year, but every single day.
所以主复活的中心思想，我们不是只有一天来记得，我们必须要每天都记得。
It have to be preached every single day.
我们也要每一天都向别人传扬这样的福音。
Tell your friend, tell who didn't know Jesus. Jesus is the law of resurrection.
你要告诉你的朋友，基督已经从死里复活了。
And then he can change your life.
而且他可以改变你的生命。
He can overcome death.
他可以胜过死亡。
So that's not a one-day event.
所以这不是一天的庆祝活动。
It has to be remembered and preached every single day.
这是我们每天要记住并且向人传扬的福音。
And of course, Jesus do not want this event to be related to pagan tradition and practice.
当然，主耶稣更不希望我们来纪念他复活的事情跟这个复活节有任何的关系。
Because those are related to pagan practice.
因为那些是跟异教的崇拜有关系。
So now we know whom we believe.
所以现在我们知道我们所信的是谁。
The more we cherish.
我们就更珍惜他。
May the Lord help us.
愿主帮助我们。
Let's all sing hymn.
我们一起唱赞美诗。
205.
205首。